in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. Switch, kick, and land. Now I want you to start slow. We designed this workout to go a little bit slower so that you can really focus on your technique. Take the time. So if you want to modify this and really break down the footwork, follow Jess. I want you to chop the arm down your thigh. That's going to help you engage your core. Keep your guard up. Looking good. Now you don't have to kick high here. Think about your kick target. You could go for the knee, maybe to the stomach of your opponent. That's great. Now, one of the most common faults people have on these kicks is they lock out their kneecap. I don't want you to do that. Keep your knee nice and soft. You never want to hyperextend. Look at about 20 more seconds, and then we're going to hit up our first conditioning spike. We're going to be there for 30 seconds. You remember that? Awesome. So stay with it. Check this out. This is the spike. You've got one push-up and a diagonal knee. Knee is coming to the opposite elbow.
Let's hit this down here so y'all can see me.
3, 2, 1. Drive the knee across the body, crunching the ribs to the hips. Now chin is in, eyes are forward. If you need to pull it back, Jess has got you covered. Now, your chest should be dropping down at least to elbow height. Okay, if you can get a little lower like Jasper, that's beautiful. Everything's long and straight. Stay with it, come on. We're gonna come back up on our feet, non-dominant stance. Everybody up in 3, 2, and 1. Repeating switch, snap, kick, go. Switch, snap, kick. Kicking through the ball of the foot. Now, like I said, you're in your non-dominant stance. So that means it might feel a little bit different. That's okay. So revisit all the technical points we just talked about. Kicking through the ball of the foot. Keeping your knees soft.